be attentive so that God will speak to you, so that God will meet you at the very point of your time. Amen. Praise the Lord. And you are going to see another great move of God tonight. Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. We have, you know, God's servant in our midst, and of God that he hears us. Many of us know his wife, Sister Grace, the choir leader of Holiness in Baphomet, Lagos State. We were here 2 years ago when Jamoa came here. Praise the Lord. He's a man of God, evangelist, preacher, same time he's a singer. He's a man with many paths. Praise the Lord. He has experienced God in a very unique and a very wonderful way. The way he is sharing with us a few things tonight, and at the same time, he will be praise and prayer that will change your life. Amen.
Amen.
Lest you forget that we are still on the journey. Our glory, land. Amen.
Amen.
So we have those of us who are Revealed by a mission group, Facebook, you must have seen it's posted on our page. You see that Jacob is the one, and I don't know whether you have been a boost. If not, someday we will praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we have a man of God, very practical, very useful instruments in the body of Christ. Amen. So I want you to join me as we welcome evangelist Jacob. Already to be in the spirit as I sing this song. Talk to God. What did you want God to do for you tonight? Already to talk to God. When he shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I there in the found dressed in his righteousness alone. Faultless to stand before thy throne. I'm crying as a song, literally I stand all around and around his genius power.
I can't.
And your father told you that if you come back, he will have mercy on you. I come here tonight to tell you that Jesus Christ is ready to forgive your sins. Jesus Christ is ready to welcome you back. Even though your parents may forsake you, he will not forsake you. If your Lord is telling you that heaven has never forgiven you, take that mind in a liar. Tonight, I want to announce to you, because you have repented, heaven has forgiven you. For it is written in Revelation 8 verse 1, now therefore there is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who live no more after their former life, but live it according to the new nature of Christ Jesus. Lord, I want to speak your word. Let it not be my will, but from the truth. Speak to me. Let the entire life be given to these words. Give it unto me myself. We will go this journey successfully. Our fear will never be terminated on the road. We will succeed in this journey, whether the time of it or not. And by what we proceed forth, we shall destiny the world. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You have a seat. Listen to me. Whenever you are listening to this message, I came to you tonight with a great message from the Lord. This message is a divine revelational message and also a divine insight in the Word of God. And the topic, right, take the Bible and write. The topic of the message we want to look into tonight is why women go naked and the female garment of the saints spotted. Why would they go naked? The second family. Why would they go naked?
Why would they go naked?
Pure children of the saints. Pure white children of the saints.
Pure white children of the saints.
Spotted.
Spotted.
The word spotted can also mean stain or dirty. We are talking about why people go sucking. Why would they bless sexy? Why they go freeze you on the road? And the pure garment of the saint is spotted. It is a critical issue we are facing today, even in the church. And this issue must be addressed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord gave me a divine revelation of the reason why everywhere around we is sounding alarm on dressing, on appearance, on moderation. Because something has gone wrong in the spirit. And this practice that the devil is using to destroy many saints now is founded in the Bible. So the strategy of the devil was not constructed by himself. But the devil and an accuser found a place in the Bible to accuse brethren. And this discovery of the devil is what leads to what we are calling the beauty pageant today. I'm going to explain to you. Let's read the Bible. Matthew chapter 5, verse 27 to 30. We must be wiser than the devil. Because our mind was considered, we must succeed. Whether we like it or not. If the devil has made you to make a mistake tonight, repentance will take judgment.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are reading Matthew chapter 5, verse 27 to 30. Look into your Bible. I want you to follow me as I'm reading. I'm reading from verse 27, Matthew chapter 5, from verse 27 to 30. I read. Amen. You have heard that it was said to those of whom, you shall not commit adultery. But I say to you that whoever looks at the woman to lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart. If your right eye causes you to sin, run it out and cast it from you. For it is more profitable for you that one of your members perish than for your whole body to be cast into hell. And if your right hand causes anything you say, cut it off and cast it from you. For it is more profitable for you that one of your members perish than for your whole body to be cast into hell. I want to read verse 28 again. Verse 28 is where we drive our team. Why we are going and the pure garment of the saint spotted. But I say to you that whoever looks at a woman to lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart. Amen. The great lesson I'm sharing to you now happened when I was in the presence of God in my own time, praying, asking God to help me to cross over. And once I had a vision I had when I was with her in a revelation, and I discovered many people are serving the devil without them knowing, even today. And that is why you must preach the gospel. Somebody said you must preach the gospel. Many have never heard. Don't keep quiet. When it is confident or when it is not confident, preach the gospel. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As I was in the presence of God meditation, praying in my quiet time, the angel of the Lord came and called me and said, "Son of God, God, I want to show you what the saints must know and why our present preachers, people all over the world, to begin to cry on dressing, on moderation, on appearance, on adornment." I told the angel of God and we wait. And the place we went, as he described to me, is called spiritual Egypt. And in that spiritual Egypt, what happened? The devil was having their international world conference. The devil was having their international world conference. The place where, like a stadium, all the demons in the world was present in that meeting. But no human being was there. It was a secret meeting to decide against human being. The angel of God took me, we stood somewhere, watching the meeting. And Satan made a statement. Satan said, "Are you not people, are you people not seeing what is happening? The rapture is about to take place." I said, "Eh?" So even the devil is monitoring the time that he says. We are careless about this issue, but Satan is more careful about this issue of rapture than he says. He told them, tell me people forgetting our agreement that God drove us out from heaven and created man to come and take our place. And we took the decision that man must not take our place. But what shall we do? We must do something because every indication is showing that that man is about to take his sense. And if this thing happens, that means our thought, our labor is for him there. Our decision is that man must not take that holy place. Satan is a liar. Somebody said Satan is a liar.
Satan is a liar.
I want to announce you that if the man will distract others, he will not distract you.
Amen.
For the reason that his secret plans are exposed, I want to tell you, he will not distract you.
Amen.
Jesus will help you.
Amen.
Jesus will surely help you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the devil on this question, he started to explain, he told them, that before Christ was crucified on the Calvary, he was explaining it because of Pilate and they don't put any details on it. He was explaining to him. They were playing and I was watching the demonstration of what happened before the crucifixion of Christ. Satan told them, and they know that since that time, that man had been beaten. And the life of the God himself, see, that day he got his morning meeting. And what was there? They showed how they got one conference meeting and how to provoke God to God's men, to God's men to sin against God. And Satan demonstrated, they demonstrated it. In that meeting, on the formal meeting they had, they asked a question. What shall we do?
We prepare God to destroy men.
Some of the demons brought out for nations, and they caused that generation to commit the sin Solomon and Gomorrah committed, plus the one that the generation of Noah committed. And they succeeded in letting that generation to commit these atrocities joined together. And at length, they are committing those atrocities. They build what they call pyramid prison. They are demonstrating it. The pyramid building is like a white glass of pyramid standing on the floor of the transparent block. As people are committing sin, that pyramid that they were being eaten up, they are taking it through the scale of that pyramid. So the day came when all the demons came and watched the pyramid, they destroyed and weak, they are monitoring the anger of God from that issue. But lo and behold, when they discovered that their dimension was working, they celebrated it. They rejoiced that very soon, God's anger will be released against man, and God will destroy the man. But to their own surprise, the day they were expecting that pyramid to collapse was the day Christ was crucified. So they shout hallelujah! The day they were expecting the anger of God to destroy man was the day that Christ was crucified. I was there standing with the angel watching the meeting. I could not tell them that since that time, till now, and he never again said, until then he called this last meeting called Satanic Modern Meeting. And this thing was going on. Satan asked a question, what shall we do? If we don't do anything, these people will be answered. To my own surprise, all the demons brought out the Bible. I was looking at the Bible. I was trying to see if I can see because the Bible looks as if it's King James. I was surprised. They are using the original Bible. I was like, even if I am looking for what? Why can't they go to educational or old scientist lab to go and find for against man? Or there are many gods people are serving on earth. Why can't they go to their books or their own way to find for? But they took the original Bible. Somebody said the original Bible. Somebody said original Bible. This came to my understanding truly as the whole world came to compound that this will be books of books. If you have this book and you cannot be able to restart the secret in it, you have to be blamed. This book itself is Christ. It's Christ. This book we are looking at, the Bible. The Bible is the book of life, the books of books. All the demons are researching the Bible, To my own surprise, one of the demons signified that he has found a place that this generation cannot be able to escape. They are looking at. It's okay. Can you declare the demon quoted Matthew chapter 5, verse 27 to 30, precisely 28. And the demon read, when a man or whosoever looked at a woman and lost after her had committed adultery with her already. Whosoever that looked when a man looked at a woman and lost after the woman, that man and that woman, they have committed adultery together. They said, yes, this is the word of God. Listen to me. This is the word of God. A big generation cannot be able to escape it. They started to analyze this scripture. They said, well, this scripture aligns with the technological application of this generation. This particular verse of the Bible aligns with technical application against this generation. They said also that one good thing about this particular portion of the Bible is that Christians will be saying, after all, I've been with my husband since 10 years, since 5 years, I'm married, I never want to sleep with another man, not knowing that a prostitute in a chalet is better than you. A woman will be saying, hey, after all, I've never met any woman, or since I'm married, I've been keeping to my own wife, not knowing that a prostitute in a chalet is better than you. They said again, chapter is that when a Christian makes mistake and falls into sin, maybe in prostitution or sleep with another woman in this act of fornication or adultery, that Christian will always have it in his mind, I will repent. But that when you look and lost, your mind will not even tell you that you have committed sin. Don't place up to ask forgiveness. They will be analyzing it one after the other, one after the other, one after the other. And they will be analyzing, a demon came out and said, we have sent her much. We have sent men much that are bad to women of God, but they couldn't seduce those women. We also sent her out to miss the pastors. Those harlots couldn't seduce those pastors because they knew that these people are a bad person. What shall we do? That was a discussion among them. They came to agree that if they want to seduce a Christian, that person must rise up from among the Christians. Get me very well. If you go outside, your business partner may offend you. You will easily forgive because you know that he doesn't know. But you will be surprised that when a fellow believer, even in this church, in this place, in this ministry, offend you, you will flip up immediately. You know why? You don't expect that temptation to come from that area. It takes maturity to act to overcome it. And that is the reason why you see some men, some women, they will go to places, people will offend them. But when your wife offends you in the house, something that you should want to forgive, you become very difficult. Because you don't expect that nothing will come from your wife or from your husband. But wisdom calls your attention, knowing that this is the condition of Satan. Not your wife, not your husband. Please forgive your wife, Forgive your husband, for your own good. They begin to point and point and point and point and say that if a prostitute or a bad man, we think a sister that is holy, that sister will not fall. After their conclusion, they don't say okay, that they will enter into the church or among the so-called holy brethren. They will produce the mind of one of them, and that person will come to be a temptation to others, and there's no how. They will escape it. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor. Don't be an instrument of Satan.
Don't
be an instrument of Satan. Come to your side and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Don't allow Satan to use you. Say yourself. Call your name. Godwin. My name is Godwin.
Yes.
You will be the evangelist of Jesus.
You will be the evangelist of Jesus.
Not the evangelist of Satan. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Listen to me. And to my own surprise, they demonstrated it. And it didn't work perfectly. And they demonstrated it with the idea of watching them. They showed a congregation that is having program. They have a special program. And that congregation invited a minister. And that minister happened to be a woman minister. He had a blessing. Service was going on. Everybody had been seated as we are seated now. And the pastor was moderating. Surprisingly, the invited guests with other men of God, they came in. And they are coming in group. The man of God said that the congregation should clap unto God and welcome the woman of God to the podium. To my own surprise, everybody was clapping. I was looking at the lady for my own judgment. If I should judge as a man, the woman dressed very well. Because the woman dressed as a bank manager, if I should find a work in a corporate way, she wears suits and dress corporate. For me, I don't see anything bad on her dressing. Are you getting me?
Yes,
but as she passed through the congregation, now went to the altar, as she was about to sit down, her skirt did not go down very well. Her skirt did as if her pants opened. You know, everybody just went on her up to the podium and all eyes were still on her. It's as if all eyes looked to her heart. Immediately, something like only, you know, when you untouch, bam, the light will just go with speed, bam. That is how something like only, now spring out from her congregation. And nobody saw it. Immediately that they showed it, come and see celebration. They started celebrating it, that this formula has worked. This pastor ended up sending the whole congregation to hellfire instead of preaching them or leaving them as even she married them. It's even better to leave them as she left them than letting them twice if you don't care. And we stood against the demon. As the angel was standing on the door, while I was quoting the Bible, telling my neighbor that their blood was their mountain, was their mountain, because give them a high roof and a dry breast. And I was showing in a reflection of hell that I was. I'm not going into it now. And the demon made a statement. When the scripture was so much, and the fire was so much, that demon then thanked me. That dressed seducively, not called a servant. I made a statement. I said, you Christians are dreaming, seeing vision of heaven, but they don't know the glory of heaven. And we have been in heaven for a long time before God drew us out. We are the people that are the glories of heaven. We are not dreaming, neither are we seeing vision, but we know what heaven is all about. I want to tell you that the beginning of jealousy is that no man will enter heaven. We must make sure that you people must not go there. For God created man to enter that glory. Heaven is too great. And we have vowed that as long as God drove us naked, we must make man and woman to go naked, and they will not go there. I want to tell you, this is why the Bible said it. Since the death of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. And only the violent takes it by force. I want to tell you, the appearance of Jesus Christ and the preaching of the John the Baptist and the manifestation of the New Testament made the secret to become known. Everybody knows it. Everybody knows the truth. That is why he must not allow anybody to deceive you. The heavenly race is not greater than God. If anybody tells you that heavenly race is greater than God, that person is a liar. He is better than God. The Bible knows we not say, he is overcome. We get the crown of life. He has endured to the end. We get the crown of life. For you to endure to the end, for you to overcome, that is your first battle. Heaven is on the high standard of the high glory. But it is about on Sunday, I have a great message to tell you. When you stop secrets, they will give to you. Top secrets of the world. You know, a heaven is real, and God has planned for you to make heaven. As we are watching the meeting, Satan started explaining the time when they created, if you have had Baphomet before. Let me tell you, I was there, we were watching them, the whole truth, I have the whole truth. Satan started to explain, the Baphomet you are hearing about today is what the Bible called Jezebel. Jezebel in the Bible. The same Jezebel of Old Testament that met Christians in the time of Elijah. The Bible told us that when this woman saw all these harlots, the mother of harlots, that's what the Bible called her. Jezebel, the mother of harlots. When this woman found herself in the throne, the Bible told us that Israel for us God. Now nobody recognize God again. See, Elijah was thinking that he was the only one remaining. When that woman came to power, this evil spirit, which is my own and queen of heaven. That's what she has. First with fornication, adultery, faith, and idol worship. She called the children of Israel to come to Ashram and power. After many years, this demon manifested again. They were demonstrating it. Thought we were there listening to them. the shoot, the devil came back from the Baphomet as part of our body as a woman, part of our body as man. They said that after they tried this, but it's like me, I'm understanding what they have, what they are doing. So there is a need to re-strategize their way. They started explaining that for that thing to show man and woman in one body is showing sex contradiction. Sex contradiction. That's why you see a woman, we like to wear what belongs to a man, and a man, we like to wear what belongs to a woman. Sex contradiction. God will not in Deuteronomy chapter 5 and 22. Man shall not wear what belongs to a woman, and woman shall not wear what belongs to a man. And they quoted the scripture, we are the kindest. That is, there is all the strategies of Satan. He's an accuser. All of them were derived from the Bible, the original Bible. I will tell you that not any accusation that has no backup from the Bible cannot stand. Even if you ask you, that's why the Bible says, any tongue that can enter against us in judgment, we shall not condemn it. Whatever be the accusation the devil has found in you, today Jesus was told us that if we confess our sins, He is able to forgive us and to have mercy. Today, the one who is approaching with the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Yes. Listen to me. This continue. So that I'm going to explain how they move from here, the Baphomet we are talking about today, and also the Illuminati we are talking about today. How they move from Jezebel to Illuminati, and they explain that secret of Illuminati is drive from what? Power of Amen. Power of Babylon. To man, they presented it to man as one world. When I read the Bible and woman what human done, they wrote it as what? Confucian strategy. Confucian strategy. It oneness of disobedience. That is in their own kingdom. But to man, they presented it as what? Warfare strategy. As one word, I mean. And they also drive it from what? Power of Babylon. Well, what am I trying to tell you? At this great rebellion, Queen of Heaven and Queen of the Coast, surprisingly to me, appear. Satan, Queen of the Coast, naked herself as a woman, in the midst of this congregation, and Queen of Heaven started to decorate her with other demons until they made her up. They made her up. She wear only panhead, painted nails, pants, and brazier. And now started to demonstrate catwalk in their midst. Catwalk. To my surprise, her catwalk was catching those demons. Was catching those demons. They were being seduced. After that, there was a celebration about them. And within their celebration, they said, we have seen one man without the evidence. And from there, listen to me. We are seeing what men cannot be able to escape, and each and every child cannot escape it. Come on, see celebration. Come on, see celebration. Come on, see celebration. They are heading these demons. Heading them seriously. For a researcher for this generation will not escape. At the end of the day, they now ask, now we have seen that there are demonstrations, no man will escape it. Even demons cannot even escape it. What can we do? What can we do to transfer this demonstration to the earth? At the end of the day, the demon, Queen of Heaven and Queen of the Coast came out with a strategy called beauty pageant. So this is what the formation of beauty pageant we are hearing today. And I do not also write, even Christians, some churches in this Lagos, you will see them. They have their own beauty pageant. Some place run away. Just before they are agents of darkness. Beauty pageant is the graduation of rebranding of Jezebel. From Jezebel to Baphomet. And from Baphomet, what we are hearing today is what? Beauty pageant. And what is the main aim of beauty pageant? Beauty pageant is look and lust. Look and lost. Miss what? Miss what? Miss state. Miss streets. Miss Lagos. Miss this. Miss black. is to generalize it, to segment it, so that it will reach every home, reach your own land. The main aim is what? Look and lust. You go to Facebook. From there, Facebook is their platform, is their home. Facebook is their home. The aim is what? Look and lust. You go to internet, try about Instagram. The aim is what? Look and lust. When you look at the mirror, a picture of her parents, and you look at that other person, a prostitute in a child is better than you. And there is one critical statement they made. That's one critical statement. I had a witness at the end of this story. Because as we are watching, that Jesus Christ never leave us alone. Somebody shout hallelujah. They say, that means, no matter whatever good you call that person, and somebody look at you and not after you, there is a problem. And there was celebration. Are you getting me?
Yes.
You call that person that you have dressed very well, and somebody look at you because of that person and not after you, there is a problem. They said within themselves that the scripture cannot be broken. That if God deny it, that they will accuse God against Sodom and Gomorrah. This is where, on my own judgment, I became careful on this so-called dressing. We have had many teachings, we have had many things. I said, God, we need your help. Somebody said, God, we need your help.
God, we need your help.
In this heat of their bragging, they are bragging that they can actually not escape it. One of their main bragging is that they can pollute almost all prison, that they will never ever remember to ask for forgiveness. Because their mind will not go that they have committed sin. There was celebration for this discovery. And there was a quote, what I mean a quote, they demonstrated a quote with it. A quote, a Roman word, or a paper. They said, a digital prostitute. They said, a prostitute in a challenge. Listen to me very well. A prostitute in a challenge. This is the voice of Satan. From whatever the calculation they came out with, they are the thoughts. They now said, a prostitute in a chariot may sleep with 5 men in a day. While a digital prostitute may sleep with 2 million souls in a day. Powered with street catwalk and social media. Let me read it. A prostitute in a chariot may sleep with 5 men in a day, while a digital prostitute may sleep with over 2 million souls in a day through cosmetics and sexy appeal, powered by street catwalk and social media. Quoting the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 28. If a man look at a woman and not after her, he has committed fornication or adultery with her already. It doesn't matter whether the prostitute is a pastor. It doesn't matter whether the prostitute is in the church or a housewife or a co-house. Flee! Run away from there! They are their core enemies. Don't play. Don't go there. Be it the students. Be it the church leader. Whosoever you be around you, that person going to lead you to hell. Don't listen to that person. At this heat of their bragging, Jesus Christ appeared. To my own surprise, as we are standing, I saw Jesus folding his hand like this. See how I hold my hand, wearing his pure white garment, and coming with a sorrowful voice and a quiet voice. I say, my son, I saw Jesus came down from heaven and stood there with your standard, watching these people. He said to me, he was crying seriously like a baby. He said to me, my son, go to the world and tell my people that my Father is ready to help. And also, I myself is ready to forgive. Go and tell them that from now onward, that when they go out as they are going out, they should ask for forgiveness. And also, as they come back to their homes, that they also should ask for forgiveness. That every sin they ask for forgiveness, that he is ready to forgive. So they shall hallelujah. Satan is planning. God also is planning. That is why I announced to you that when you sin, it is not sin against Satan, it's against God. And the Bible told me that another man has no power to judge another servant. That's the servant. You are a servant to Jesus, not a servant to Satan. He has no power to condemn you in that sin. Your master told me to tell you that if you can confess your sins and repent, he will forgive you. If Satan is using the Bible, we also will tell him that we are not ignorant of the Bible. When he met with Jesus Christ in the book of Luke chapter 4, in the temptation in the wilderness, he quoted the Bible. Jesus Christ told him that he is the Bible himself. And because he has enough is greater than he has in the world, he is a loser. Somebody open to us before we end up. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9.
First John chapter 1 verse 9.
Yes.
If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness.
Praise the Lord. I read again verse 8. So if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. Nay, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You cannot hide it from God. You cannot hide it from God. You don't cover your sins. You don't cover your sins. You cannot hide it from God. He's not willing that you should die. He's willing that you should be saved. Brother, this is your right hand to confess your sins. I want to tell you, anything that is preaching to you, I cannot lie before God and before man. The sin of Luke and lust, if God did not call your attention, you will not die yourself. When it goes sucking, temptations every year. Technological sins, sins of the heart. The Bible says, he said it's not key for the heart of God against your brother, against your sister. This is the technological sin. He are a killer. He cannot change the Bible. You and somebody have been abortion is the same thing. Why can't you forgive? That is why I want to say forgive your wife, forgive your husband. I am a married man. I want to tell you sometimes, if you are not careful enough, he can forgive everybody. But when you come to the person that loves you or who you love, he will say, if I expect trouble, it's not from this person. I want to tell you, forgive. I want to stand on our feet. Jesus is available for you. Is there any way that you have found yourself in sin? Are you look and not the one of the ruler? Listen to me. When you reach your house, I don't pay attention to verse 28 and 29. It was in your explanation and religious place. I don't understand what that place means. But in this encounter, I understood that place. That place said when your heart causes you to instead of your heart to take you to hell, you should cut it off. Instead of your eyes to take you to hell, you should plug it out. That place doesn't mean that you should carry knife or fuck and the faith, I mean, and remove your eyes. No. What your place means is this. If it is eyelash that wants to take take you to hellfire. Deny your money, that Allah, so that you will save their soul. Or else, like Esau, they punish, or they drop their birthright. Amen. If it is your leg, maybe fornication, want to take your way to your heaven. Deny your parents that fornication, so that you will enter heaven, that you satisfy yourself with that desire. At the end of the day, you go to hell. Can you talk to the Lord? I don't know that. Is it money? Is it anger? Is it fornication? Is it attraction? Is it passion? How many people have you sent to hellfire through your passion? Are you falling into this trap? Jesus will forgive you now. I am not here to condemn you, but I am here to preach the preference, forgive you, sanctification, and purification to you. But Jesus sent me to bring this for you. Only if you can accept him in your life as the Lord and personal Savior. Come here. No longer in the path of sin to run. Come here. Lord Jesus, I am coming home. Can I tell you something to the Lord? I said, Lord, I have sinned against you. Have mercy on me. Deliver me from these messages. Make me wiser than this devil. I have sinned against thee. Let me stand him. Are you standing? Are your children standing? Even in the house you are living, is this temptation? Your eyes, we know you need to have. The eyes of the loss of eyes, the pride of blood, and the loss of flesh. These things will not make you hellfire. Can you talk to the Lord? Say, Lord, help me. Help me. Let me wiser than the devil. Jesus told me to confess, I will be forgiven. Help me to confess and sin no more. I confess my shortcomings now. I confess my shortcomings now. Wherever you are, listen to this message. Yes, maybe you're listening to it online, in your television, in your house. Maybe in the church, or in your car, anywhere. I want you to talk to the Lord seriously. I said, Lord, my past sins, cannot forgive them. Jesus told me to tell you that he is ready to forgive. As we are going out and as we are coming in. And because of daily activities, daily application, he is ready. His father is ready. He is ready to help you. Have you backslided? Because of these temptations. Return back. You need to make. Go and meet your pastor. Jesus is ready for you. Remember, do not cover your sins. Don't cover your sins. Jesus is ready for you. Your confession is when the word of blessing. You will be out of that crowd. You will be out of that crowd. Jesus said, if no one condemn you, I condemn you not. He who not is forgiven, love the Lord. The more he forgives you, the more he will be. He will forgive you. Remember, confess your wife to confess your husband. Don't worry, Jesus will forgive you. You will not go to hell forever. You will say, I'm starting to take you to hell forever. But Jesus will cause you to tell you, there is a way of escape. If you are here, your work is back here. It's away from that work. You will go to hell forever. I tell you the truth. If you are here, your work is to be divided for the rich see. There's your clothes. There's your dresses. You dress. You put your hair like when you are time. I want to tell you, the prostitute, the challenge is better than you. Why can't you drop it today? Make a change. Jesus will forgive you. Jesus will have mercy on you. Disappear from alcohol. Disappear from any manner of sin. Jesus will have mercy on you. He will forgive you. You are not dressing like that, but you like them. In your offices, it like them for their gears. You are starting to be dressing sexy. You are looking at them, looking at them. Listen, as you are licking your tongue in a lot of them, so is hell. Hell by licking tongue to receive you. Yes, in dress well, but people that are leading, they are agents of darkness. If you go to hellfire, when the Lord took me to hellfire, I saw two ladies taking me to go and bring their mother, who was collecting the money for their prostitution, to hellfire. Because when they were playing this gambling, and she was eating the money with them, be careful. church today is under 21 days prayer and fasting. Pray that they must make heaven. Pray for other Christians also. I want to tell you guys what this message reached you today. He must receive it. He must receive it straight away. Jesus, we help you. Jesus, we help you. Can I make it to the Lord? You are here. You need the help of God. You need the help of God. To run your Christian life successfully. You can, I want you to come back here. Lord of God, we pray for you. Come back here. Lord of God, we pray for you. These are the nations that are getting as we look at earth. Weakness every corner. Jesus will give you the strength to overcome. You will overcome. As if Jesus received, you must succeed. I tell you, as Jesus received, you must succeed. You are Jesus received, you must succeed. Jesus will help you. Jesus will help you. I'm prophesying to you today. Jesus will help you. Jesus will help you. Better than I help you, I cannot help you. In this matter, Jesus will help you. When you never say to the Lord, can I hear you talking to the Lord? And say, Lord Jesus, I must make heaven. Help me. I repent today. I repent today. I must make heaven. Help me. Forgive my sins. And we are falling short. Forgive me.
Today, the life of Jesus Christ is what I am giving.
a memoir. I stand on the word of God. I claim my assurance of repentance. I claim my victory in Christ Jesus. I testify today, because Jesus Christ was seated, I must succeed. Because Jesus Christ overcame, I must overcome. Because my sins are forgiven on the cross, holiness is possible. Because I have accepted Jesus Christ in my life, and I have confessed my sins, righteousness is possible. Heaven is possible. I must succeed. I must succeed. Lord Jesus Christ, take over control in my life, or be I see you to fix the heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Begin to talk to the Lord. Begin to talk to the Lord. He considers you must succeed. He will help you. Tell him, sir, help me. Help me. Jesus will surely help you. When you are weak, Jesus will be your strength. Paul says, the good I want to do, I find myself a devil doing it. But if what I want, I find myself doing it. Glory be to Jesus, who will help me. Jesus will help you. Jesus will help you. Jesus will help you. Jesus will not condemn you. Don't condemn yourself. Sister, don't worry. That mess that you are thinking that you are messed up with your life. We prove the love of God upon you. For whom much is forgiven, much, he loved me much. Mary Magdalene, this Mary that poured oil on Jesus Christ's feet is a prostitute, and demons must come out of it. It's a prostitute, and the same Mary is the one the Bible is talking about. The person that poured oil is from the family of Martha and Lazarus and Mary. This person, much was forgiven. This happened, and she loved much. Because the sins are forgiven, you will love Jesus the more. You will love Jesus the more. You will love it more. Father, thank you for your knowledge. Be in the spirit and the word of God pray for you.
Yes, I'm on the path. Come, repent and have the arms of your grace, the arms of your mercy. We have some the cleansing of the Lord. If you mark records of iniquity, who shall be saved? There will be time in our lives that we speak. But as we have come out to spoke to us with a repentant heart, we ask, O God, precious blood, and the grace to overcome on a daily basis over the spirit of loss that have dragged in on countless number of souls to hell. Grant us that grace to overcome this spirit in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God, as many who are standing here who are truly repentant in their heart, I pray to God of glory, no one will be found wanting when the trumpet will sound. The devil will not rejoice over us.
Amen.
In the precious name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name.
In a great house there are vessels unto honor and to dishonor. Lord, make me a vessel to honor for you, Lord. In a great house there are vessels unto honor and to dishonor. Whosoever pours himself shall be a vessel unto honor. Make me a vessel, make me a vessel, make me a vessel unto honor. There I may be a true servant in your vineyard. Unto wrong, Lord, I want to be a vessel unto honor. Father Abraham was a vessel, he was obedient and righteous, he was humble. Dwelling daily in your most holy place, bringing solution to all mankind. Be a vessel unto runner. Make me a vessel, make me a vessel, make me a vessel unto runner. Servant in your vineyard, make me a vessel, make me a vessel, make me a vessel unto runner. Lord, I want to be a vessel unto runner.
We are fearfully and wonderfully made to show forth the praise of God, for our body is the temple of God. Just like in the days of old, in the days of Moses, in the days of Elijah, and in the days of David, the glory of the Lord filled the temple. You dwell in the Ark of Covenant. Today, my body is your Ark and your temple. But I pray tonight, make me a vessel unto honor. Make me a vessel.
Make me, Lord, to be a vessel. You are the fountain. Shows us not, not we. No man takes this honor to himself unless he is called as Aaron, filling with the Holy Ghost to intercede for mankind. Make me a vessel, make me a vessel, make me a vessel unto honor, that I may be a true servant in your vineyard. Make me a vessel, make me a vessel, make me a vessel. To honor, Lord, I want to be a vessel unto honor. Lord, I want to be a vessel unto honor. Lord, I want to be a vessel. To be a vessel unto Rome.